There is a program of God that produced this church. What is the program? The church of Jesus Christ has departed from the faith of the apostles. Apostle Paul said, examine yourself if you be in the faith. The church of Jesus Christ departed from the faith. I always say it. If you are sincere with yourself, if you are sincere with yourself, and you study the Bible, and you take your eyes away and look at what is happening in Christendom today, if you are sincere, oh, I say sincere, you will ask questions. And you will soon find the answer that the church has departed from the apostolic faith. What you see today is not the original church that started on the day of Pentecost. But nobody can defeat the purpose of God. He said, I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail. He will think he has succeeded. Satan thought he has finished mankind through Adam and Eve, what they did in the Garden of Eden. But God was looking at them. Before there is a problem, God has provided the solution. Does that mean something to anybody here? No. No, it's a nugget. It's a nugget. Before there is any problem around you, every true child of God, I'm talking about the children of God. How many of them are here? Thank you. Put down your hand. Before there is any problem that will come to you, a solution has already been provided. So that you will understand why the Bible says Christ, Jesus Christ, was crucified from the foundation of the world. Before Adam and Eve was created, Jesus Christ was already crucified. Why? Through foreknowledge. Jesus Christ was crucified in the mind of God that he will be the one, knowing in advance that Satan will try to disturb his program on earth here, knowing that as he will be creating Adam and Eve, Satan through serpent will come to scatter it, knowing in advance, he also provided the crucifixion of Jesus Christ to bring us back to what he has intended it to be. You cannot defeat the purpose of God. Hey, somebody shout, Satan, you're a liar. Say very loud. Before there is a problem, there is a solution. Hallelujah. My reverend doctors of divinity cannot understand why the last chapter, the last verse in the Old Testament, the last prophet that we know recorded in the Old Testament, the book of Malachi, the prophecy of Malachi, as he was ending the Old Testament, he said, behold, I send Elijah the prophet. Hallelujah. Before the coming of the great and dreadful day of the Lord, Malachi chapter 4, verses 5 and 6. He said he will do two things. Turn the heart of the fathers to the children, and the heart of the children to the fathers, lest I come and smite the earth with a curse. Listen, church. No doctor of divinity knows the meaning of that prophecy. That is the greatest mystery in Christianity today. It is the ministry of restoration. God was going to use an anointing to turn the heart of the apostolic children. We are the children of the apostolic fathers. Turn our heart back to their faith. And he did it through the ministry of William Marion Braham. That's why we sing that song. God's attributes were manifested to his bride in this last age. We have caught the revelation by the last prophet's message. And we know who we are. And what we are made through. Yes, sir. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
But the original. Original Christianity. Original faith. Back to the Bible. Back to the apostolic.
It's what I believe. Son of
man. Oh, the Son of Man.
It's revealed that seven sin will be your
bed. The original.
Original sin.
Our eyes of understanding. Our eyes of understanding. He has opened.
Victory is ours. Who will stand down in the past?
To Jubilee has sounded, and we have responded to our God. Who is original? Oh, the original.
The original sin. The original world. It's what I believe.
The Son of Man
is revealed that seven sin will be on them.
The original. The original. I want to say something. That's why I'm doing this. To help us. How many people love my prophecy? I'm a prophet. Hey, you like my prophecy? Don't worry, I will not go that way. I will not go that way. Where will they go? The area that you don't like, I'm not going that side. Sister, relax. I'm not going that way. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. I want to, if you catch this thing, I want to tell you now. Amen. You will travel, you will go home boldly. Amen. Hallelujah. You don't even know how special you are because you don't know who you are. And you don't know who you are because you don't know what God is doing now. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. When they say God's attributes were manifested to his bride in this age, he didn't say to his church in this age. He didn't say to the church. He qualified to the bride. Revelation chapter 19. He said the marriage of the Lamb has come and the bride has made herself ready. Amen. There is a difference between a bride and a concubine. A difference between a wife and a concubine. And it's the most unfortunate when a wife does not know that she's a wife. When a bride does not know that she's a bride. But we know who we are. We are the apple of God's eyes. We are untouchable. Hallelujah. One of the stanza in that song says, we are the word made flesh today. This is what the scriptures say. And our names are seen within. Redeemed and perfect without sin. Yes, we are anointed and inspired by our God, who is original. We are the Word made flesh. Do you know the meaning of that? I said a little bit of that on Sunday. You don't know the weight of that statement. Eh? One of my daughters today, you know, this is the season for this is the season for get money at all cost. I was saying, so I can help you. She was inside the bus. She could remove her purse and all her money when she gave for life be that. She saved under her portmanteau in the room. Now she won't carry and go bank. She can't open the zip of the purse. Come bring the money, pay. Now in those people, then they inside, they see her. These people, these ones, they don't carry arms. No gun, nothing. One of them came by her. Holy nose and blow. on top of her. Then she turned and said, what is this? Why she say, what is this? They are operating in her bag. So shine your eye, shine your eye. This is the season. This is their season. This is their season. Next time, if you know you are carrying anything valuable, anybody that distracts you, before you listen to it, secure it first. Give another person a bed, hold this thing for me. Why you put this on me? Anyway, she came crying, and could not be pacified for a long time. Hours after, in face, it stood boom. Then I call her, I say, how did you know you are an unbeliever? I was shouting at her, see me living with an unbeliever. Hey, come and see unbeliever living in this house. He said, waiting. I said, the Bible says, in all circumstances, you should cry. You are not a believer of the Bible. Hey, the Bible says all things work together in all circumstances. Give that. If you are a believer, when they thief your money, you come down from the motor, you discover and say, Father, I thank you. Father, I thank you. Father, I bless you. How many believers are here? That one hurt. Eh? That one hurt. That one hard. But the Bible says we are the Word made flesh. We are created for His purpose. If God has created you for His purpose, let me show you a man that He created for His purpose, the Lord Jesus Christ. He created Jesus Christ to come and enjoy on earth, Abby. Yes. He created Him to come and be a king on earth. For 1,000 years, Jesus Christ, He's going to be a king. Do you understand what I'm saying? That is what He created Jesus Christ for. He created Jesus Christ to be a king. He will rule for 1,000 years in His own time. Satan will not be available to disturb Him. Satan will be in the bottomless pit. What a glorious kingdom it will be. But before He will go to that kingdom, how? Wahala there. He suffered humiliation, pains, rejection. They nailed Him, gave Him the most cruel death a human being can have. But He was fulfilling a purpose of God. All things work together for good. In all circumstances, therefore, do what? Do what? Give thanks. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Every step you take as a believer, I would still want to ask, how many believers are here? Put down your hand. Do you know what you believe? You should have found out. What do you mean? Believe what? If you ask first. Believe that this scripture is from God. How many people believe it? Lift up your Bible. Say, I believe this Bible. Say it. Say very well. Yes, put it down. How many believers are here again? Thank you. Put it down. Put it down. See. Hey. Go and study this God we are serving. Once you are connected to Him, you are connecting yourself to Him for a purpose. And anything you find as you try to live your life to please Him, yet you meet some unusual circumstances that you think one that has the mighty God that He is behind it should not undergo it. But you see yourself undergoing it. Always know that He, God, knows the way through the wilderness. Always know that whatever He allows you to go through, it is to enable you fulfill a purpose. And God is not obligated to explain to you what you are to go through. What is written is written. Praise the Lord. Have this verse at the back of your mind as you decide to follow Jesus Christ, including my daddy in Salami from London. That is it, oh. That is it. That is it. If not, how can we explain such a boy? He used him to deliver his son, his father, and took him home at the age of 17. Did he achieve God's purpose in his life? Yes. That was his purpose, God's purpose. So before you grumble, amen. Now why I'm saying all this, church, is for you to understand how special we are. When you say we are the Word made flesh, what we're saying is that what is written in this Bible is going to be fulfilled in us. It is written, all that shall live godly in Christ shall suffer persecution. There will be people who live godly Christian life and they will be suffering persecution. Anytime you are suffering, okay, don't worry. Praise the Lord. The Word made flesh is my sermon I want to preach. Why cannot preach on now? It's a sermon I'm preparing to preach. It's another message entirely. The Word made flesh. When I preach it, you go know what I mean. So that you position yourself. But I only want to also emphasize here that we are special people. And that the interest God has in you is more than you know. You mean more to God than you know, you think you know. You see, look, anybody I know that is an instrument of God, for instance, and you have any problem, they attack you, you are sick, you collapse, fall down, it's a minister of God. You know, see, I don't stress myself. When I see, now who? Now who? Now Sunday, Ogwajo. You don't go die. You say, why? I say, you don't go die. Why? Praise the Lord. Because I know that God is more interested in him than any witch or wizard. Not even he himself, with all his carnalities, can stop the purpose of God in his life. I know it. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Listen, church. Listen. God is more interested in you. That is the confidence we have to come here and ask our God to cover us with his protection against all the nonsense going on around. God himself will send men and women that will protect you until your purpose is achieved. And when his purpose in your life is achieved, he doesn't leave you to be messed up. He will take you home in a glorious way. In a way that everybody will know the hand of God is on this person. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Now, so we are part of a move of God in Christendom to get the attention of a people back to Bible Christianity. That is who we are. God sent a message to the church of Jesus Christ. And every message comes through a messenger. And the messenger that brought the message to the church, no messenger has ever been sent to the world that was accepted. No messenger that was sent, they did not accept Noah. They rejected even Moses before he ran away. They killed Isaiah. They killed all the, that is why Jesus Christ called and said, called the Pharisees and said, you whited sepulchres. They killed everyone. Parable there shows what they were doing. The Bible stories are there to let us know. The same thing they did in this age. The messenger that God sent to this age, they rejected him. They write all manner of books and lie. Dr. Luke Oya of MFM. He lied that William Bryan died a drunkard and that they did an autopsy and they saw a lot of alcohol in his blood. Ha! A man of God lying like that. Hashimulowo wrote the same thing. Robert Lyoton, in God's general book, he wrote the same thing. I'm calling their names because they wrote them in books. Anybody that say anything against your father, if you're a true son, you will rise up and defend your father. I'm a son of the prophet. I am a son of the prophet. William Branham is my prophet in this age. He's my prophet. If not for the ministry of that man, if not for the ministry of that man, I would have gone the way they are going. The most anointed man that ever existed in this age, the man William Branham. What do we call him? Which title do we call him? Till now, all his followers call him Brother Branham. I heard even his son, Joseph Branham, was making a speech and referred to him as Brother Branham. He said, if you love me, call me Brother Branham. While the rest are struggling for titles. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. And Satan thought that he has covered the message of William Branham. A man that God used mightily like that. Many of you here, it's only through this ministry you heard that name, William Branham. That is it. They did everything to cover that. But nobody can stop the purpose of God. And we had preachers of entire message, pastors, that the devil jumped and caught them and closed their mouth. Until with all every town, this entire message is there. But nobody knows anything about this message because of the way they carry it. But God raised up another ministry, the Bride Assembly Church in Jesha. They try to stop us. They can't. Hallelujah. Listen, church. My name is Moses. There's something about that name. And I will live true to my name. I say I will live true to my name. Moses was known to be very humble. I aspire to be another Moses. Meek and humble. So pray that I will be meek and humble. Amen. But Moses, the battle I face now, that Moses no face him. So the way I will fight, not be the way we fight. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Moses was sent to Pharaoh, the denominational Pharaoh. What was the message? Let my people go. When he got there, there were magicians in those churches. The sign that Moses was given, miracles, signs and wonders, the magicians also did it. Moses threw his own, bought land and built his own. Amen. Make I talk. Listen, church, I have said this several times. Magicians were in the palace of Pharaoh to keep God's people in bondage. Moses threw his snake to show that he's from God. The magicians also threw their snakes. But the snake of Moses swallowed up the snake of the magicians. Hallelujah. The snake of this Moses. We swallow up every snake of every magician snake in this place. We swallow it up. Swallow it up. Swallow it up. And to stop us, they came and demolished this church. 1 year ago, they demolished this church. And they thought it is over. But who will speak and it will come to pass? When I, the Lord, have not spoken. And we are still here. And we will remain here. In the name of Jesus Christ. I want you to answer me 4 times and claim it by hitting the ground. I say we shall remain here until Jesus comes. In the name of Jesus. Listen, church. If not for the ministry of William Marion Braham, I will have been Reverend Dr. Professor Moses Alu. It's not a t-shirt I will have been wearing to come here now. I will have worn with a big cross on my stomach. Yes. There would have been a special seat for mommy and daddy. Yes. Praise the Lord. My wife would not have been, imagine, some of you have been here for more. You don't even know who my wife is. If you don't know my wife, let me see your hand up. You never see her before. You don't know her. You see? Which church you go when you're not going to know your pastor wife? G-O wife. G-O wife. I get wife, oh, honey. Come, let them see you. Come, honey, come. Come. See my wife. Let this one not get wife. Who find reach this woman for this church now? Just look at her. Just look at her. Look at her now. Eh? Tell me any Jew you know where your wife find pass this one. Who talks say, oh, no, Mary. For the past 26 years we have been together. 27, she reminded me, say now 27. Okay, now 27. For 27 years we've been together. Praise the Lord. But see where should you go sit down? Go back to your humble seat. Praise the Lord. I don't think that she doesn't know Bible. If I make mistake, as I reach out, she'll see what you talk. Now lie, yo. She go show me. Yes, praise the Lord. If not for the ministry of that man. And people are wondering all over the world that we should have branches. Would you have branch at Abba? Would you have branch? I hear branch. That is what the denomination produce. What is branch? Tell me the branch of Apostle Paul's church. And show me his headquarters. Amen. Praise the Lord. Listen, church. When you come here, God is giving you opportunity to be part of this great move to restore a people back to the Bible, ready for the rapture. And if you come back to the Bible, there is the scriptural way of doing everything. Somebody shouted the due order. Go and get a copy of that message, the due order. There is a due order. God's own way of doing his own things. Church, listen. I was giving you the example of the man that went and his wife, according to their tradition, he went and slept. And his wife slept with somebody else. And according to their tradition, when you get to know you sleep with that woman, you will die. Now, he believes he's a Christian. He agreed with his priest that that now that you are a Christian, you should not, you know, follow that type of tradition, because there is something that we do traditionally to break that spell. And a sister asked me, should a Christian go and do such a thing if you discover your wife did it? I said, listen, church. Listen. I answer, in case you didn't hear my answer, let me repeat it. Be sincere with yourself. You are not a Christian because you decided to go to church. I am emphasizing this aspect because we have come to put on the armor of God. Listen, church, the armor of God is more than all my enemy fall down and die. Anybody can say it, including that your enemy too. Listen, church, to put on the whole armor of God so that you become untouchable by the enemy is more than dry fasting. In fact, that you have to do dry fasting to escape from the enemy is evidence that you are not covered. Oh. Praise the Lord. Praise. Anytime before you receive anything from God, wherever in the whole world you are listening to me now, if before you receive anything from God, you always do some dry fasting before the thing will come to pass, it's evidence you are not properly connected to that God. You are only benefiting from His mercy. He's a merciful God. He said, make a joy, help this one, we're going to die for nothing. What will be your problem? Husband. Now he fast, so day. Hey. Also, don't catch you. Everything. Oh, mercy. Take. Go and marry. When I fasted, try fasting. Now I can't get husband. Then, small time now, fruit of the womb. Then you remember how you get husband. You start again, try fasting for fruit of the womb. Or small time, somebody want to call your husband, go. Then you remember how you get him by fasting. So you start fasting again. Which type of father will have his children relate with him like that before he gives them what they're looking for? Luke chapter 11. If you being evil know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more? How much more? Blessed be the name of the Lord. He said, just ask and you will receive. He said, just ask. He said, you ask. I mean, he said, you know, you don't fulfill the principles, you will receive. And the principle does not include dry fasting. Nowhere in the Bible that you receive anything from God through dry fasting. You see, the problem with us is that we have been misled. And for us to come back to the true faith is going to be difficult. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. John chapter 15. I want to see a statement Jesus Christ made today that should give all of us some confidence. Now, in John chapter 15. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Verse 7. He said, if you abide in me and my words abide in you, ye shall ask what ye will and it shall be done unto you. That is the secret of receiving from God. Not fasting. Not dry fasting. If you abide in me and my words abide in me, because you can abide in him and his word will not abide in you. He said, why call you me Lord, Lord, and do not my commandments? He said, then you will ask whatever you will and it shall be done to you. Amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord. So when you come here like this, praise the Lord, we thank you again to the rudiments, the basics, basic tenets of Christianity. Go back. See, I was sent to Kaduna Polytechnic in 1979 by the Nigeria Air Force to go and read accountancy. Now, in my secondary school, it was a military school. I did not read anything commercial subject, so I didn't know anything about accounts. There is the introductory class before you go to ND1 and ND2. But when I got my admission, the first took me to go to secretarial studies because they wanted me to come into the administration. My first day in class, now let me be man. Everybody there na woman. Now I come out. I said, which kind of school be this? Only me be woman. Only me be man. All of the women. I went to the head of department. It was a white, my Pakistani man. I said, I don't like that thing. Only me man. He said, yes, sir. I said, no, I don't want it. I said, give me another course. He said, okay, go and read accountancy. I went. Instead of introductory class, they jump 1 year straight to the first year. I'm talking, there's a reason I'm giving that example. And then I said, when I sat down in the class, the man was, and I was already about 3 months late. So they had gone 3 months ahead. What did they talk? Debit, credit, final account. Then he finished, the man finished. Then he said, all right, okay, we were only 30 of us in the class. He said, okay, now prepare the final accounts. So everybody, then he was going around. He reached me, I stand like this. I look at him. He looked me, I look at him. He said, who is this? I said, sir, who is this? Where are you from? I said, sir, I don't know what you people are doing here. He said, he looked at me, he said, you better pack and go back to who sent you come here. And he walked away. I felt so bad. I went to the head of department again. I said, sir, the class you put me is too high for me. Can you bring me 1 year back to introductory class? He said, no. He brought my file out. He looked at my secondary school result and said, is this not your result? I said, yes. You have this result. You can. That is why I say we should not waste your time in introductory. Go there, you can make it there. I said, ah. I went back again. I said, let me try and see what in the talk. Listen, we are not sincere with ourselves. That's the problem. Imagine a student going to head of math and say, demote me to another class. Because I don't know what I'm doing there. So what I did was, I got angry. I said, accountancy, that's the only subject, Abi. I stopped coming to class for 1 month. I went to bookshop. Principles of accounting, those of you read accounting, Favel. Book one, book two, book three, all of them. Then Saturday, every day I would go to the library. No nightclub. No woman. No beer. Every day in the morning till night, I come back. I said, I must finish. I read and read and read until I caught up with where they were. Then I now relax. And I passed out with my certificates. Listen, church. The problem we have is that many of us have a supposition in Christianity where you know nothing about Christianity. You know nothing about salvation. Instead of you to be honest enough to drop your doctor of divinity, to drop your school of theology certificate, and come back and sit down, humble yourself, and find out what is justification, what is baptism of the Holy Ghost, what is sanctification, What is it? At what stage is a man saved? Study this ABC. You are going to read algebra when you don't know ABC. That is the problem with Christianity. Let somebody drop your pride. Humble yourself and let God begin to teach you again. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Salvation is not by assumption. There is a confirmation that you are belonging somewhere. That you have left somewhere. You belong somewhere. It's not somebody telling you, say after me. People have messed it up. People have become members of churches and think they are members of the body of Christ. You can be a church member even when Christ will not know you. People are confused with the anointing. And they don't know that at that day. The Lord will say, not all that say, Lord, Lord, shall enter into the kingdom of God. But he that doeth the will of my Father, which is in heaven. Many that day will say, was it not in your name? I am quoting Matthew chapter 7. At that day, many will say, was it not in your name? I cast out devils. And all the mighty works that they did. And Jesus will say, I didn't know you. There are people that are doing miracle signs and wonder Jesus doesn't know them. That's why Peter said, make your calling and election sure. Why? Because many are called, few are choosing. Hallelujah. You may be a member of choosing church, yet may not be among the choosing of the Lord. You may be a member of the redeemed church, yet you may not be redeemed. You may be a member of Celestial Church, and yet you remain terrestrial. You will claim you are a winner. Meanwhile, you are a loser. Yes! Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. If you go to the wrong embassy, you will never get the right visa. You may be a member of Christ's Embassy Church and not be a member of the embassy of the Lord Jesus Christ. When I say it, serpent seeds will be getting angry with me. When I speak the way I speak, children of the devil, whose father is Cain, beefier spirit, who have nothing in them to repent, they'll be getting angry with me. Hallelujah. Throughout this program, I will be teaching you what is the true armor. So that when you move, you're a time bomb. Blessed be the name of the Lord. The Bible says, ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. Imagine somebody, you're not sure where you are, and you refuse to go and do that sacrifice in the village. Go and do it all and save your life. If there is any culture, any tradition in your village, if people don't do it, they will die. And you refuse to go and do it because you go to church, because you are elder in your church, you are usher in your church, because you go to school of theology, because you gave yourself title. Because everyone that has a title in Christianity, he gave it to himself. There is nowhere, nobody of men, anywhere constituted according to the Bible to give title to anybody. The Bible tells me it is he himself that gave gifts to all men. And to some, what? Apostle. Ephesians chapter 4 verse 11. And to some, what? Prophet, and some what? Evangelist, and some what? Pastor, and some what? For the work of the ministry. Any other title you have, you know you gave it to yourself. Amen. I know pastors that have become reverend. They started telling people, look, address me reverend. And the truth is, you will see some places where William Branham is addressed as Reverend Branham. Listen, the word reverend is an English word for anyone that is highly rated, highly revered, because of, you know, some supernatural spiritual thing around you. That is why anybody that is revered, highly revered, then people call you reverend. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. One of the things we shall be doing in this program, listen very well. One of the things we shall be doing in this program is water baptism for those who have not been baptized. And I will tell you the importance of water baptism for those of you hearing it for the first time, and why your denomination does it wrongly. I will show you according to the scripture how it should be. I traveled to Equatorial Guinea, and the church that invited us there, their geo after service, they are watching us now. He told me, he said, sir, truth is truth. He said he saw water baptism for the first time. It's like that they were doing it wrongly. And he came out of Assemblies of God to start his ministry. And that is the second largest church in Equatorial Guinea. And it is tied to your deliverance. It is tied to your deliverance. Water baptism is tied to your deliverance. For every believer, it's so important. We'll just speak about it. And when I speak, finish, you go ask me questions, because some of you believe more in your denominations than the Bible. During this period also, listen, church. Amen. During this period also, we will be doing some prophetic actions. This Tuesday, as we are coming back here tonight in the night, here tomorrow night, Tuesday night, come with a sachet of water. Listen, I was telling people, because, you know, the Christianity has gone so formal, until when you want to do any spiritual thing, somebody who has been going to church for years, you will sit down and explain and explain and explain and explain before, if not, the person will say you are occultic. There are prophetic actions. Listen, church, in warfare, he said, the Bible says, you know, we wrestle not against flesh and blood. He said, although, hallelujah, listen, church, we wrestle not against flesh and blood. Spiritual warfare. Once you're a Christian, you are into a warfare. Now, listen. Before any soldier man, any unit, anybody, I was looking at the television earlier in the day, and I saw that in Central African Republic, that they sent French troops to come, and then all those rebels, they arrested them. And I was saying, why will it take French troops to come? We are the government troops. Foreigners come from Europe to an African place, and they arrested them. What the indigenous soldiers could not do. And I look at it, why? It is because of the gadgets those people have that these ones don't have. From there, they use their gadgets, their satellite. They saw where they are, where they're hiding. In Boko Haram, we are in France. It will not last 1 month. They will capture all of them. Why? Because they have the equipment, the gadgets. Before you go to a battlefield, there is the intelligence unit that will go and find out their strength, the kind of weapons they have, and everything they'll be using, their own battle plan, so that you can plan and counter their own. So it is spiritual. You are in America. Nothing is working for you. And you are wondering what is happening. Unknown to you, in the village there, They don't carry your name. Tie them somewhere. Keep them somewhere. As you they go, that's where you go call. They don't touch you. They use padlock, lock somewhere. They use one cage, drop you there. They use one rope, tie you there. They use one mirror, they monitor you for Lagos. Anywhere you go, hey, they go interview. You go, see how they go, yeah, yeah. And then they follow you and disturb it. And the same person is sitting, Uncle, how was your interview yesterday? Pray, oh, pray, oh, pray. Oh. Now the person when they deal with you, they tell you, pray. Oh. Amen. That is why we take that water. Water signifies life. Put in a cage as a point of contact to somebody whose life is in a cage somewhere. As I smash it here, wow! So let it be smashed. If you say it like that, you smash it. Wherever that cage is gone, and you are free here. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Though we walk in the flesh, we do not war after the flesh. It's a battle, it's spiritual. And so, and then that is why too, we will open padlock. Bring padlock. Enter message believers around the world. They have said all manner of things against me. For the things we do here to set the people of God free. Hey, where is it in the Bible? Where is it in the Bible? Church, listen. We are returned back to the Bible. What we mean is, don't do anything contrary to the Bible. The Holy Ghost is still speaking. It's a living ministry. It's a living ministry. Some of you here in your dreams, God gives you a solution to your problems. But because of your denominational background, you don't take it as an instruction from God. You remain in your bondage. Here, we will smash mirror. Any mirror where they watch me as they come to cause accident on the way, I smash it to pieces. As you smash it here, then go search for you the day when you they come. Then go carry the mirror, they don't go see her. Then go search there, then go see cloud to cover it. How many people believe it can happen? Yes. 3 days ago, I saw a newspaper accident on the road there. A woman that was coming from her wedding, in her wedding gown, serious accident. I say, hey, they pursued this girl so they reach her wedding. From somewhere, somebody is monitoring you. The car you are going to drive, the car you are entering, when he reached that bridge, he go divert and make him enter. They say, oh, na trailer cause him. No be trailer. That is why here we will break mirror. We have come here to put on the armor of God. We will stand here. So many of us here, witches and wizards, stand and begin to cast spell and call your name in a shrine, in an evil altar. I too, by higher power, we will stand at this altar. And we will reverse them. Reverse them, reverse them, reverse them. That's what we'll be doing here. Praise the Lord. On Saturday night, we will bless the oil. Sorry, Sunday, we come here for Thanksgiving. The last aspect of it, on Sunday evening, we shall do two things. We'll bless that oil. When you travel to your village, when you reach there, and I've told you, anytime you want to do any action for deliverance, make sure it is secret. Don't let anybody see you do it. When nobody is looking, dig any part of that house, pour that oil. Anything they bury for there, it's on fire. Amen. And at the end of the evening of Sunday, we will now go and renew our covenant that was sealed with the blood of Jesus through communion service and feet washing. Your leg, we shall wash your leg here one by one. Amen. Wash one another's leg. That leg will not match poison. Anybody that carry your sand, the footprint from the floor, it carry fire. How many people believe it will happen? I am a deliverance minister. Anything I tell you to do for your deliverance, just do it. I'm talking to the children of God. Praise the Lord. That is what we'll be doing. Thank you very much. I don't finish my own.